Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shri Vasade Gaur Bhaktavinda Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So we're hearing about Prajapati Daksha, who offered the Hamsa Goya prayers to the Supreme Lord. So the Lord was very pleased with Prajapati Daksha, and he knew that Prajapati Daksha desired to increase the population. So now we're going to hear how the Supreme Lord replies to Prajapati Daksha. So the Lord tells him, he tells Prajapati Daksha that it's very good that you have a lot of faith in me. And that's why now you're experiencing devotional ecstasy. And I know you've done a lot of austerities as well. And that austerity, along with your devotion, means that you've achieved complete perfection. So in the Bhagavad Gita, Lord Krishna also says that when we realize the Supreme Lord, that's our greatest fortune. So the same way in our Krishna consciousness movement, we try to train people and teach people how to achieve perfection in life. That we know this material world is a temporary place of suffering. We want to get free of the suffering of this world. Okay, so then he says, the Lord says to Daksha, he said, because you've performed so many austerities, I know you did it for the welfare and for the benefit of the world. And the Lord says, I also want to see everybody in the world happy. So the Lord tells Daksha, I'm very pleased with you that you're trying to help to fulfill my desire for the good of the world. You know, at the end of the world, when the material world is annihilated, then all the living entities, they all have to take shelter in the body of Karana Dakshaya Vishnu.
Karana
Dakshaya Vishnu means Mahavishnu.
Karuna Dakshaya Vishnu 意味着是, 它其实就是 Mahavishnu.
And then when there's creation again, then they come from the body, they come out from the body of Mahavishnu.
而当创造再次发生的时候, 这些生物体又从 Mahavishnu的躯体中出来。
And they come out in all different species of life.
他们出来以各种, 不同的生命形式出来。
So we may wonder, why are the living entities, why do we have to be put into this conditioned life and suffer the miseries of the material world? So the Lord said to Daksha, he said, it's good, you have a desire to benefit people and save them from suffering.
主对当时说，你想帮助这个物质世界的人们，想让他们免于这种痛苦，这是非常好的。And
the Lord said, I also want to do that. I also have that desire.
主说，我也希望这样做，这也是我的愿望。But
the living entities who come and who contact the material world, they have to be corrected.
但是那些来到物质世界想跟这些物质世界接触的这些生物，他们必须得得到一定的纠正。Because
they've all we come into this material world because we've not surrendered to Krishna. We've gone against him.
因为这些来到物质世界的这些生物，我们之所以来到这里，是因为我们反对 Krishna。
And because of this, living entities are conditioned, they take birth again and again in the material world. So there's a chance for them to get liberated. But the conditioned souls, so foolish, they don't take advantage of this opportunity. They just want to have sense gratification, and so they stay in the material world and take birth again and again. So Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita that we have to surrender to him, and then you can get free of the material energy. We're tiny parts of the Supreme Lord. But we're struggling with the six senses, we're struggling with the mind and the five senses. So this struggle, this is because we're not cooperating with Krishna, we're not surrendering. And because we don't surrender, so we have a lot of struggle trying to fight against Krishna. So Srila Prabhupada explains how Krishna consciousness is to try to elevate people to the spiritual platform. And if we don't come to the spiritual platform, then we'll just stay in the material platform and we'll stay in the material world. Sometimes we'll be in heaven, sometimes we'll be in hell.
有些时候我们会去天堂,
this is what conditioned life means. You go up and down, stay in the material world.
这就是受条件限制的, 这个状态上上下下在这个物质世界。
So Daksha was trying to benefit the conditioned souls. He was trying to help them.
Daksha 想帮助这些受条件限制的灵魂，想给他们一些益处。
Try to help them to get liberation. Means liberation means to surrender to Krishna.
Daksha 想帮助这些受条件限制灵魂获得解脱。解脱的意思是臣服于 Krishna。
So if one wants to have children in the material world, the whole purpose of having children is to train them to be surrendered to Krishna.
如果我们想在这个物质世界要孩子的话，要孩子的目的就是为了训练这些孩子能够臣服 Krishna.
So that's very good to be a father and to train your child to surrender to Krishna.
如果能够训练孩子能够臣服 Krishna 的话，那么成为一个父亲是非常好的。
In the same way, the spiritual master trains the disciple to surrender to Krishna.
同样的，灵性导师也得训练他的门徒去臣服 Krishna.
So, if the conditioned soul, if he gets a chance to become Krishna conscious.Then that's the mercy of Krishna.
如果一个受条件限制的灵魂，他得到一个成为有 Krishna 知觉的机会的话，这也是 Krishna 给予他的仁慈。
So all the acharyas, all the members of the Krishna consciousness movement, try to benefit the conditioned souls by giving them Krishna consciousness.
所有的先辈尼尼性导师，所有的 Krishna 知觉运动的成员，都在努力地想给受条件限制的灵魂给他们帮助，给他们益处。
So this is real welfare work. This is really for the benefit of the conditioned souls, the ordinary people.
这是对普通大众，对所有受条件限制灵魂的真正的福利性的事业。
So anybody who tries to spread Krishna consciousness, then he gets recognized by Krishna.
任何传播 Krishna 知觉的人，他都会得到Krishna 的赏识。
Krishna says in the 18th chapter of the Bhagavad Gita.
主 Krishna 在《薄伽梵歌》的第十八章中说
Natatasman manusheshu kaschin me priyakritama.Anybody who teaches this message of Krishna consciousness, then they're guaranteed to go back to Krishna at the end of life.
对像奉献者解说这个至高无上的教导的人，他必能够回归于我。
And he said, there's no servant in the world more dear than that person.
而且在这个世界上没有一个仆人比他跟我来说更亲近的。
And there will never be one more dear than this person.
将来也不会有更亲近的。
So Lord Brahma, Shiva, Manus, all the demigods in the higher planets who are increasing the population, they're all working for the benefit of the living entities.
主 Brahma, Shiva, Manu, 还有高等星系的所有这些人，他们，都在增加人口，他们都在为生物的福利而活动。
So, these people are like incarnations of the different qualities of the Supreme Lord.
这些人相当于是主的品质的化身。
Yeah, there are different types of incarnations and expansions of Krishna.
主 Krishna 有不同有各种各样的化身或者扩展。
And you've got expansions of Krishna's own self. And there, that's called Swamsha expansion.
比如说他的个人扩展被称为 Swamsha。
So these expansions are all Vishnu Tattva.
这些他的个人扩展都是属于 Vishnu Tattva.
But then there's other things which are not Vishnu Tattva, but they're just Jiva Tattva.
还有其他的一些，他们不属于Vishnu Tattva范畴，他们属于Jiva Tattva范畴。
They're called Vibhinamsha. Vibhinamsha means separated expansion.
他们被称为Vibhinamsha，意思是分离的扩展。
So Daksha is not on the same level as Lord Brahma and Lord Shiva. But because Daksha also does devotional service, he's compared to them. It's not that Lord Brahma is very great, and an ordinary person who's just a devotee trying to preach is not great. It's not like that. There's no distinction like that. It doesn't matter if one may be materially high or materially low, but anybody who's doing service for Krishna is very dear to Krishna. So from the scriptures it said that from Lord Brahma down, all the living entities are engaged in the service of the Lord, and they're all extraordinary. And they're called Vibhuti. Means the opulences of the Lord.
这就是主的富裕.
And then the Bhagavad Gita also in the 10th chapter, at the last verse, Lord Krishna also says that Yadyad Vibhuti Matatvam Sattvam Srimad Sri Urjitam Evacha Tat Eva Vagacha Tvam Mamma Tejo Mishasambhavam. Krishna is saying, know that all the beautiful, glorious, and mighty creations are but a spark of my splendor. So when a jiva is able to act on behalf of Krishna, then he is called Vibhuti. Is like the opulence of the Lord.
But
the Vishnu Tattva, the Lord's incarnations, such just like Matsya Avatar, they are called Vibhava. So you've got Vibhuti, which are the living entities, and you've got the Vibhava, which is the Lord Himself. So Krishna was saying, just by a single spark of myself, I can support the entire creation. So that spark, that is the super soul. So the Supreme Lord is still speaking to Daksha, and he calls him. He says, my dear Brahmana, austerity is such like meditation is my heart. In other words, very dear to me.
至尊主还在给这个 Prajapati Daksha 说，他说：“我亲爱的 Brahmana， 冥想的形式的这些苦行，冥想形式的苦行，是我的内心，像这种苦行对我来说是很亲切。”
So meditation, that's Satya Yuga. People like to do meditation.
Meditation 就是冥想，在 Satya Yuga 黄金年代，人们喜欢做，人们从事这种冥想。
So then the Lord says, Vedic knowledge and hymns and mantras, he said, that's my body.
主说，伟大的曼陀罗，伟大的知识，这是我的躯体。
And spiritual activities and ecstatic feelings, that's my actual form.
灵性的活动和狂喜之情是我的形体。
So all the rituals and sacrifices, they're like the limbs of my body.
宗教仪式、祭祀，这些是我身体各个躯体的躯干。
And the pious and spiritual activities, that's my mind.
灵性的活动是我的心意。
And the demigods who follow my orders are my life and soul.
那些执行我命令的办事人是我的生命和灵魂。
So sometimes you get atheists who say that since God is invisible, so they say there can't be any God. They don't believe in God.
有一些时候那些无神论者他们看不到神，他们不认为神的这个存在。
So, for people like that, now we're hearing a description by so that we can see God.
对于这样的一些人，我们可以用现在我们的这个经典的这个形式呈现给他，他们就可以看到这个神。
But we have to see him in the impersonal because we don't believe in the personal. So Krishna is telling us how to see the impersonal form.
而这个形式是一种非人格的这个形式，因为他们看不见神，所以呈现的是一种非人格的形象。
So intelligent people can see God in his personal form.
而有智性的人。则可以以人格的形象看到至尊主。
That's in the scriptures.
就像经典所说的。
But if somebody is very eager to see Krishna immediately, face to face, then he can see the Lord through the descriptions given in the scriptures.
倘若一个人非常渴望面对面的见到至尊人格首身。那他可以通过经典看到这个主。
Because the scriptures, like here, is describing how to see the different parts of the body of the Lord.
经典在这里也描述了主的不同的部分。
So the first principle of spiritual life is we have to do some austerity.
灵性活动的第一个部分是我们得做一些苦行。
We have to give up material activities.
我们得放弃一些物质的活动。
And then we take up spiritual activities, like perform Vedic ritual sacrifices.
接着我们再做一些灵性的活动，比如说伟大的仪式。
Or study the Vedas, study Vedic knowledge.
或者研习伟达经，伟达的知识。
Or meditate upon the Supreme Lord.
或者冥想至尊主。
And chanting the holy names, chanting the Maha Mantra.
唱诵至尊主的圣名，唱诵 Maha Mantra.
And we also have to respect the demigods.
而且还应该尊敬半神人。
And we have to understand how these demigods are, what they do, how they act. And how they manage all the different affairs of the material world. So then, that way, then we can see how God is actually there and how everything is actually being taken care of by Him. Just like in the Bhagavad Gita, Krishna says, the material nature is moving under my direction. So if somebody cannot see, if we cannot see God, although He is present, although He's Krishna, but if one cannot see Him in His different incarnations, then you can see Him in the impersonal feature. When we work under the direction of the scriptures, then that is called Dharma. That was already described by the Yamadutas.
Yeah.
Whatever it says in the Vedas, that is Dharma. That's the real principles of religion. And the opposite of anything of that, then that is irreligion. So the Vedas, they are the Supreme Personality of Godhead Narayan. So that was stated by Yamaraj. And the demigods, they are all acting under the protection of the Supreme Lord. And they also get some protection from the Supreme Lord. Okay. So then before the creation, there was only the Supreme Lord. Of course, the Lord at that time, he has his own spiritual powers. And at that time, consciousness was not manifest. It wasn't something you could perceive at that time. Just like when we go to sleep, then our consciousness is, it's not really manifest when we're asleep. So it's explained in the Vedas that the Supreme Lord is the Supreme Eternal amongst all Eternals.
在伟达经中说, 主是无数永恒者之中的至尊永恒者。
And the Supreme Lord is the Supreme Eternal amongst all eternal living beings.
主是无数永恒者永恒生物之中的至尊的永恒生物。
And he also has, the Lord also has impersonal features.
主同样也有非人格的特征。
Just like Brahman and Paramatma, they're like his impersonal features. Right. And these forms, the Paramatma and the Brahman, that's only there after the creation. not before the creation.
Brahman 和 Paramatma 是在创造之后的这个，不是在创造之前存在的。
So the form of the Lord that's always existing.
主的形象是永恒存在的。
But the Brahman and the Paramatma that comes, it's not there before the creation.
但是超灵和 Brahman 它是在创造之后。
So Krishna, the Supreme Lord, can only be understood by devotion.
因此至尊人格守神只有通过奉献服务才能够了解至尊人格守神。
So the Supreme Lord can be understood only by Bhakti Yoga.
只有通过奉爱瑜伽才能够了解他。
We cannot know him by speculation or by meditation.
我们通过思辨以及冥想不能了解他。
These things only came about after the material creation.
因为思辨和推敲等这些思辨推敲还有冥想这些事情是在创造之后的这些方法。
So the impersonal feature of the Lord is like materially contaminated.
因此这个非人格的特征有一些物质的污染在里面。
But pure devotional service, by pure devotional service, then we can understand the Lord.
通过灵性的，通过奉献服务，我们可以了解主。
And Prajapati Daksha, he saw the Lord as a person.
Prajapati Daksha, 他看到主是一个人。
And he could see the Lord was very beautifully dressed, and he had all ornaments.
他可以看到主穿着美丽的衣服，然后穿戴的也很美丽。
Of course, every person, every living entity is eternal.
当然，每一个生物都是永恒的。
But only the Lord existed before the creation.
但是只有主一个人，他是存在于创造之前的。
And after the creation is over, after the annihilation, after everything is destroyed, then only he will exist.
而且在一切毁灭之后，也只有他一个人是存在的。
Krishna appears in Vrindavan as the son of Mother Yashoda.
主 Krishna 在 Vrindavan 显现为母亲亚修达的儿子。
And Mother Yashoda, she tied up Krishna with ropes, just like an ordinary mother may treat her child.
母亲亚修达绑 Krishna 就像一个普通的母亲绑一个小孩一样把主给绑了起来。
So we don't have any distinction about which forms of the Lord are external and which forms are internal.
对于这个形象来说，实际上是没有，我们并没有对主的内在和外在的这个形象做区分。
But we should understand he's never an ordinary person.
但是我们也得理解到，至尊主绝不是一个普通的人。
He never changes. He's the most intelligent.
他从来没有变化过，而且他是最有智慧的。
The less intelligent people, they think the impersonal Brahman is a form of the Supreme.
那些没有智慧的人会认为非人格 Brahman 用的一个物质的躯体，一个形象。
And ordinary people, they think the Lord has a material body.
而且普通的人他会认为主用ordinary people think the Lord
has a material body.
普 普通的人会认为至尊主他有一个物质的躯体。
But the Lord actually has a form which is eternal, full of bliss and knowledge.
但是至尊主他拥有的是永恒知识和喜乐的形体。
And he has the original consciousness.
而且他有他原初的知觉。
Actually, and that consciousness of Krishna, that is where everything comes from. As Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita, Nat vevaham jatunasham natvam mene neme tanadipa. Never was there a time when I did not exist, nor you, nor all of these kings. And nor in the future shall any of us cease to be.
主 Krishna 在《博伽梵歌》中说：“过去从未有一个时候我不存在，你所有这些国王也是一样，将来我们大家也不会不复存在。”
So we can understand the Lord that He is the absolute truth in the past, now, and in the future.
从这里我们可以看到主的形象是。过去、现在和未来都存在的绝对真理。
But after everything is destroyed, Krishna still has his Satchidananda form.
在一切毁灭之后，主仍然有他的永恒知识和喜乐的形体。
But the other living entities, all of us, we just have material bodies.
但是我们的这些人只有物质的躯体。
So the matter, the material energy, merges into the other material energy.
因此，我们的这些物质就会融入到那些物质之中。
And the spirit soul, the subtle form of the spirit soul, that stays in the body of the Supreme Lord Mahavishnu.
而我们的灵魂的这个精微躯体就会一直留在 Mahavishnu 的躯体之中。
And we remain asleep, waiting for the next creation.
我们在里面睡觉，然后等待下一个创造。
So people who are not very intelligent, they think that Krishna's opulence is not real.
那些缺少智慧的人会认为主的富裕在毁灭之后是不存在，是不真实的。
Yeah, and they think after the annihilation, then he has nothing.
他们也认为这，他们认为就是在毁灭之后，一切都没了。
But we should understand that the opulence of Krishna is eternal, and it's always there in the spiritual world.
但是我们得了解，至尊主的富裕，它永恒的存在，永远存在于灵性世界之中。
Whatever opulence the Lord has here in the material world, that is not eternal.
主的物质的这些富裕，留在这个物质世界的这些富裕是不是永恒的。
So, the spiritual form of the living entity, he will return to the material world after the material creation.
这些个体生物的灵魂的这些灵，就是精微，就是他的灵魂会在创造的时候再一次回到这个物质世界。
And he will take another material form.
他们会再一次得到一个物质的躯体。
Just like in the Bhagavad Gita, it says, "Bhutva, bhutva, praliyate," that when the material body is destroyed, the spirit soul remains in a subtle form.
就像在《博伽梵歌》中所说的，物质躯体被毁灭时，灵魂仍然存在于精微的形体之中。
And that subtle spiritual form will take another material body.
然后这个精微的灵性的形体会得到另外一个物质躯体。
So this is for the conditioned souls. But for the Supreme Personality of Godhead, He remains eternally in His original spiritual body. So the Lord tells Daksha, He's telling Daksha, He said, I am the reservoir of unlimited potency. So He said, I am unlimited and all-pervading. And He says, from my material energy, the material world came about. And in this material manifestation, we get the chief living entity, Lord Brahma. And Lord Brahma, he's born without a material mother. So the history of the material creation is like this. The original cause is the Supreme Personality of Godhead Himself. And then from Him, Brahma is created. And then Brahma takes the charge for all the affairs of the material world. And these affairs of the material world, they depend upon the material energy of Krishna. So Krishna is the Supreme Personality of Godhead, and He is the cause of the material creation. So the all the material creation is described here. It's a form of the Lord's qualities.
Is a form of Lord quality.
Yeah.
也是主的品质的形体.
The first creation is Lord Brahma.
创造的第一个是主 Brahma.
So Brahma is the cause of all the living entities.
而主 Brahma 是所有其他生物的原因.
Actually, the Supreme Lord has inconceivable potencies.
事实上，主有不可思议的能量.
It is stated, Parashya Shakti Vividaiva Shuyate Swabhavaki Jnana Balakriyacha, that the Lord has inconceivable potencies and they're all unlimited. And He has potencies like strength and activity and consciousness.
他拥有力量、品质、还有活动、还有意识.
So the Lord and all of His qualities and forms, pastimes and paraphernalia, all unlimited.
主的品质、形体、逍遥时光以及随身用品全都是无限的.
And because He's unlimited, He is known as Ananta.
因为主有无限的品质, 所以他被称为 Ananta.
So the Lord of the universe is Lord Brahma. He is called Swayambhu, means He has no mother.
宇宙这个物质宇宙之主是主 Brahma, 他被称为 Swayambhu. Swayambhu的意思是没有母亲的意思.
So one time, Lord Brahma was attempting to create.
有一次主 Brahma 准备要创造的时候,
And he thought he wasn't qualified to do it. So the Supreme Lord Narayan said, I give him advice, and I told him according to my instructions. So he did great austerities, and from these austerities, then he was able to create 9 personalities. One of these personalities was Narada himself. So, because the Lord was able to create 9 personalities, they were all able to help Brahma in the function of creation. So we should understand, it's very important that you have to do austerity. If you don't do austerity, then you won't be able to do anything. So Lord Brahma was empowered to create the universe. That was because he did austerities, so he got the power to create the universe. And the more we do austerities, the more we become powerful by the grace of Krishna. So Lord Rishabdev always told his sons, you have to do a tapasya, you have to do austerity to get to the transcendental position. We want to do devotional service, we have to do this austerity. And by doing that austerity, the heart becomes purified. In the material world, we're not pure, and therefore we cannot do anything very well. But we can purify our existence by doing tapasya. We can do wonderful things by the grace of Krishna. So tapasya is very important. So the Lord tells Daksha that he says, there's another Prajapati, his name is Panchajana, and he has a daughter, Asikni, and I want you to take her for your wife. So, you go with her, and you can connect with her as husband and wife, and by having sex, you'll be able to produce hundreds of children in the womb of this woman to increase the population. So Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita that when we do sex according to religious principles, that he becomes that sex. It's a very pure activity.
主 Krishna 在博迦梵歌中说，我是不违背宗教原则的性生活。如果一个人是根据宗教原则做这个性生活的话，主本身就是那个活动，那个活动也是非常纯洁的。
But sex is not for sense enjoyment, it's for producing children.
性不是为了感官享乐，是为了生育孩子。
So people have a natural desire, they want to have that union, they want to connect with each other, husband and wife, in the form of sex. So they should do it to have children.
人们通常有这种倾向去从事性生活，但是他们应该从事这个活动是为了要小孩子。
So the Lord told Daksha, he said, I'm giving you this girl for your wife. He said, just so that you can have children by her, not for any other purpose.
主对 Daksha 说，我把这个女孩子给你，希望你和她繁衍后代，而不是为了其他的目的。
And the Lord tells Daksha that this woman is very fertile, which means she'll be able to have many children easily.
主对 Daksha 说，这个，你可以很容易跟她进行生育。
So Daksha was given the facility to have unlimited sex.With this woman.
而且当时得到了一个可以和她进行无限繁衍的这个能力。
So in his previous life, Daksha was also called Daksha in his previous life, but he had offended Lord Shiva in the previous life.
在先前 Daksha 也被称为 Daksha， 但是他冒犯了主席吧。
And the result was they cut off his head and they gave him the head of a goat.
由于他的冒犯，他的头当时被砍下来，然后被安上了一个羊头。
So Daksha felt very ashamed that he had such a head. So he soon gave up that body.
Daksha 当时觉得非常的羞愧，然后放弃了自己的躯体。
But he still had a lot of desires for sex.
但是他仍然保持了很多性生活的愿望。
So he did this austerity to satisfy the Supreme Lord, and the Supreme Lord gave him the potency to have a lot of sex.
他想通过他通过苦行取悦了至尊主，然后至尊主给予了他这种无限的性能力。
So this kind of benediction, this kind of blessing which was given by Krishna, the Lord, that is not given to advanced devotees.
要注意到的是，这种性的便利，这个主给予的这种性的这种便利。不是给予这些精进的奉献者。
Advanced devotees, they don't have these kind of material desires.
因为精进的奉献者，他们没有这样的物质愿望。
So Prabhupada explains, he said, if my Western disciples, if they want to advance in Krishna consciousness, he said, they should stop all this sex life.
圣帕帕的说，我的这些西方的男奉献者、女奉献者们，他们如果想要在 Krishna 知觉中获得进步，他们最好克制，停止这种性生活。
At least they should give up illicit sex.
至少他们应该放弃这种非法的性生活。
He said, even if you get the opportunity for sex, one should limit this just to have a child only.
即便他们有机会去过这样的性生活，他们也应该限制自己，只让自己为了生育而去过这种生活。
So Kardama Muni got the opportunity to have sex, but he had only a slight desire for it.
Kardama Muni 也得到了性生活的便利，但是他只有一点点的这种欲望。
So after he gave children into the womb of his wife, then he renounced everything.
当他通过他妻子的子宫得到了孩子之后，他就弃绝了这一切。
So anybody who is serious about going back to Godhead, they have to give up sex.
那些很严肃认真的想要回归守神的人，他们应该放弃这种性生活。
You can have sex only as much as needed, but not unlimited.
他们应该只是接受有限的性生活。而不是无限制的。
So we should understand that daksha that when daksha got facility for unlimited sex, this was not the real favor of the Lord.
我们 we should not think of that.
When daksha got the facility for sex,This was not the real blessings of Krishna.
Okay. 当 Daksha 得到这种无限交媾的、无限的性生活的这个能力，实际上不是主特别喜欢的这种愿望。
Daksha, we'll see in a little while that Daksha again made offenses. This time, and he's going to offend Narada Muni.
而且在后面的时间我们可以看到 Daksha 他又做了冒犯，他冒犯了 Narada Muni。
So although there's some pleasure in sex life in the material world, we have to be very careful how we handle it.
因此即便在这个物质世界的性生活是有一点快乐的，但是我们也得非常的小心。
Because there's always a risk of making offenses.
因为总是有存在着冒犯的危险。
Whenever we get the opportunity for material enjoyment, then it's very easy for us to commit offenses.
当我们有机会能够得到物质感官享乐的时候，是也非常有机会做冒犯的时候。
And we will see Daksha, he makes some offenses again.
我们可以在后面看到 Daksha, 他又做了
So you can see he didn't get the favor of the Supreme Lord.
他并没有得到至尊主真正的垂怜。
So we don't want to.Approach Krishna to get his blessings just to have unlimited sex.
因此我们不要去接，我们不要想着去接近主，要得到一个有无限性能力的这种愿望。
Okay, are there any questions?
Okay. First question from Charles Chitra Mataji.今天讲的圣典波迦瓦坛六点四点四七要旨中有一句话，至尊主的非人格特征、局部特征展示等概念，或多或少的都受到物质的污染。请问这里所说的至尊主的非人格特征以及局部去展示的概念，指的是梵和 Paramatma 如何理解或多或少的受到物质的污染 ？So today we.Mentioned in the Srimad Bhagavatam, improperly said, the Lord's impersonal features like the Paramatma and the Brahma get some contaminated by the material contaminate. So I want to ask, this Brahman feature means the Brahman.Paramatma. Hare Krishna.
Well, I don't know. I have to look at the text.
In the Srimad Bhagavatam, Canto 6, 4th chapter and verse 47.
Oh, Krishna. Just a minute. Wait. Canto 6. Six, four.
47.
47. Oh, we read it today, yeah?
Yes. In the purport.
Uh-huh. 6, 4, 47. Mm-hmm. Yeah, well, we were explaining that the Brahman and Paramatma
are the impersonal features of the Lord.
Yeah. And she wants to know.
This is the first question, whether the impersonal feature is the Brahman or the Paramatma. This is the first question. Want to confirm.
They're both. Well, no, the Brahman is the impersonal and the Paramatma is the localized feature. Or Paramatma is the all-pervading feature.
Brahman is a non-personal feature, and Chaolin is a non-existent feature.
Impersonal and localized conceptions of the Supreme Lord are more or less materially contaminated.
Yes.
Right. He cannot be understood. Yeah, well, we're explaining that they're materially contaminated because they come into existence after the creation, or at the time of the creation. They're not present before the creation. Right. So that's why Prabhupada is saying they're more or less materially contaminated. And of course, the Paramatma is a feature of the Lord. That's only present in the material world. You don't get Paramatma in the spiritual world. And the impersonal, and the impersonal feature of the Lord, that is also not, it's not in the spiritual planets, it's outside the material world, but it's like the Brahma Jyoti, right? The impersonal is the Brahma Jyoti. The impersonalists, they don't get into the spiritual planets. They only get into the Brahma Jyoti.
This Brahma not go to the spiritual.
No, it's there in the spiritual world, but it's not in the spiritual, it's not in the abode of the Lord, it's not in Goloka, it's not in the Vaikuntha planets, it's surrounding, but it's not actually in the planet. They don't enter, they may be in the kingdom of God, but they're not in the palace of God, they're not in his home.
Goloka Vrindavan, 没有进入到里边。 而且它是围绕着这个外昆塔。
Okay.
Okay.
So what does she ask?
Yes. The first question is, the second question you also mentioned. Yeah. So, Gurudev, I want to confirm, the Paramatma is not a impersonal feature. Yes, it's a localized.
Paramatma is all pervading.
Paramatma 不是属于非人格的特征，它是属于无所不在的。Okay. And the next question from Lila Avatar Madaji, 顶拜古鲁和翻译，超灵为什么是主的非人格特征？超灵不是主 Narayana 吗？那么不是人格化的吗？非人格特征有一些物质的污染在里面，至尊主不是在物质世界不受污染吗？ A basis to Gurudev, why Paramatma is the Lord impersonal feature?
Well, it's not, we said here, it's localized, it's a localized, and at the same time it's all pervading.
它是局部的，局部的，而且是无所不在的这个特征。
The Brahman is an impersonal feature.
凡是非人格的特征。
And the Paramatma is the localized, or the all pervading. It's also all pervading, but here Prabhupada describes it as the localized conception of the Lord.
这里帕帕说。这个超灵是 localized, 就是局部的特征。
Yes, you're right. The Supreme Lord is the Paramatma is there, but it's the expansion of Krishna, right? Paramatma is the expansion of Krishna. It's not Krishna directly, it's his expansion.
Paramatma 是主的扩展，不是主本人。
So we're not saying he's in.
Yeah.
Yeah?
Then she asked, we always say that the Paramatman is the Lord Narayana. So the Narayana is the personalized.
Yes.
是的，超灵是主 Narayana, 所以他也是人。
But it's only in the material world.
但是只是在物质世界。
Actually, we say Paramatma is not, we don't say Paramatma is Narayan, we say Paramatma is Vasudev.
我们没有说超灵是 Narayana, 他是 Vasudev.
Thank you.
Uh-huh.
Then she asked, the impersonal feature of the Lord, why have some material contamination inside? Because we said the Supreme Lord, in the material world, they have no contamination. So why the impersonal feature have the material contamination?
Well, Prabhupada is saying,that because it's appearing only at the time of the material creation.
因为圣帕帕德在这里说，这个非人格的 Brahman 的特征，非人格的 Brahman 它只是在物质创造之后展示的。
So he's saying that these understandings, he's not saying the Brahman itself is materially contaminated, but he says this understanding of the Lord this is materially contaminated.
圣帕巴德在这里没有说它是受污，就是说这个特征是受污染的，而只是这样去理解，在这个物质世界。
Because people are using their mind and senses to understand the Brahman and Paramatma. They're not going by Bhakti Yoga. This is the point. So the contamination is there in their process of understanding the Lord.
这个污染是指他们对至尊主的这种思考是污染的。
There's no contamination. There's no contamination in the super soul. There's no contamination in the Brahman. It's only in the thinking of these people who are trying to understand the absolute truth.
Okay. 他们就是说至尊主的 Brahman 和 Paramatma 这个特征，他们是没有物质污染的。这里所说的这个要点只是人们在思考至尊主的这个程序和方法，通过这两个去思考的这个程序和方法，这个是充满了物质的污染的。
They're not going by the parampara. They're not going by bhakti yoga.
他们没有通过师徒传承，也没有通过奉爱瑜伽。
They're simply using speculation and meditation.So they cannot understand the Lord. Alright.
Next question from Gita Govinda Mataji. Hare Krishna, 请接受我卑微的顶拜 Guru Maharaj, 也顶拜翻译和所有奉献。请问当下进行了那么长时间的苦行，他的物质愿望怎么没有被净化呢？ Obeisance to Guru Maharaj, I want to ask why the Daksha do a long time tapasya and why he cannot purify his material desire?
Yes, because he's not doing Bhakti Yoga.
因为他也没有做 Bhakti Yoga 奉爱瑜伽。
He's doing austerities.But he's doing austerities with material desire. He's not performing the activity for the pleasure of Krishna.
他做苦行，他是做苦行，他做苦行是带着这种物质的愿望还在里面，带着物质的愿望。他做苦行没有和 Bhakti Yoga 奉爱瑜伽连接在一起。
And we see many demons, they did a lot of tapasya.To fulfill their material desires.
我们看到很多的恶魔们，他们也做很多的苦行，为了他们的物质的愿望。
Hiranyakashipu did a lot of austerity.
Hiranyakashipu 也做了很多的苦行。
But he just wanted to become immortal.
Mortal.
Immortal. He didn't want to die.
他做这个苦行就是想长，就是想不死。
So it's not just doing austerity, it's not just doing devotion, but the motive. What is your motive? Are you doing it for your material desires, or are you doing it for the pleasure of Krishna?
所以我们这里要谈到的不仅仅只是苦行，不仅仅我们要有更多的奉爱。你是为了你的动机是什么？你到底是为了你的物质的愿望，还是为了 Krishna 的愿望？
So that our motive, remember, pure devotional service is that we perform devotional service for the pleasure of Krishna.
我们看纯粹的奉爱服务的定义是为了 Krishna 的快乐而做的奉献服务。
Rupa Goswami gave the definition, Anya bilasita sunyam jnana karma janavritam anukuyena krishna no shilanam bhaktir untamam. So anukuyena krishna no shilanam means that our only motivation is for the pleasure of Krishna.
我们看 Rupa Goswami 给的纯粹奉爱服务的这个定义 Anukuyanam 就是指我们唯一的愿望是为了 Krishna 的快乐。
We want to please Krishna.
我们是想取悦 Krishna.
So Daksha, he just wanted to have a lot of children.
但是 Daksha 的愿望是想繁衍人口。
He wasn't thinking that I want to please Krishna.
他没有想到我要去取悦 Krishna.
He just thought I want to have many children. I want to produce many children.
他的想法是我就想要繁衍人口。
And so Krishna engaged him in his service.
So Krishna 让他在他在这个做这样的这个服务。
Yeah, you may wonder why would Krishna come and meet them and talk to him if he's not a pure devotee.
你或许会思考为什么 Krishna 会亲自到他面前，他又不是一个纯粹的空间。
Well, and Krishna just engaging him. He's telling him, yeah, very good, go ahead, have many children. Here's your wife. She's got a very fertile womb and she can produce many children.
Krishna 是为了让他继续做他的这个服务，然后他来到他面前，甚至给了他一个，他说这是你的妻子，你可以和他进行繁衍人口。
Yeah, some women have that ability. Their wombs are very fertile and they can produce children very easily. Okay.
Okay. Next question from the Vaishnavi Vani Mataji. Hare Krishna, can the Lord...Krishna save anyone from sex life? Because until both husband and wife are devotees, then they cannot come to the understanding that sex life is only for getting Krishna consciousness children. My business is at your lotus feet. Hare Krishna, 这个主 Krishna 能够拯救其他人，就是能够把人从性生活中拯救出来吗？因为除非一个人的丈夫和妻子都是奉献者，所以他们无法来到这种理解到性生活只是为了生育 Krishna 知觉小孩的这个层面的理解上。Hare Krishna.
Well, we have to understand that having children is part of a duty of household life.
我们得理解到要小孩是居士生活的责任的一个部分。
Of course, there has to be training before you go into householder life.
当然要进入到居士生活得得到一些训练。
So that's why first there should be brahmacharya. Now people are trained in celibacy and then they're able to enter into householder life.
因此有这个 Brahmacharya 遵守的这个阶段，人们会训练如何遵守，然后再进入到居士生活。
So someone who is a good Brahmachari, they will make a good Grihastha.
因此，如果他是一个好的 Brahmachari 遵守生，他会进入到一个好，他会也会成为一个好的 Grihastha.
So you have to follow the Vedic system. It begins with women should be trained in chastity.And the man has to be trained in brahmacharya.
女性要学会贞洁，男士要学会如何的遵守。
The man should be trained not to waste his semen.
男性要学会如何，不浪费他的精液。
Because the semen of a man is like gold.
因为男性的精液就相当于黄金。
So you have gold, you don't want to waste it. You want to use it and keep it, and you save it and use it when you need it. And so, gold is something very valuable, and semen is also something very valuable.
因为黄金是非常有价值的，所以一个人的精液它也是非常有价值的。
But if the man will not waste the semen, then it will give him more bodily strength and good, strong and sharp intelligence.
如果一个人有，如果一个男性有很保持他的精液的话，他会更有力量以及更有智性。
But people who easily waste their semen, then they can their health can be very much badly affected.
但如果一个人很容易就浪费他的精液的话，他的身体不会很容易就不那么健康。
So generally, people are not aware of these things. They don't know how to make the best proper use of their life.
通常人们并不了解这些情况，所以他也没有很好的利用人体生命。
They don't know that semen is actually coming from blood.
他们不知道精液其实是来自于血液。
And Prabhupada said, he said it takes 30 drops of blood to make one drop of semen.
30滴血液造就一滴精液。
And it takes 30 mouthfuls of food to make one drop of blood.
而你吃30口饭，相当于才只能造就一滴血液。
So people should be taught these facts, and then they'll be more careful about wasting their semen.
因此，人们应该被教导这些事情，他就不会浪费他的精液。
Okay.
Okay. Next question from Yogita Sharma. Hare Krishna Gurudev, my humble obeisances to you and all the devotees. Dhruva Maharaj had material desire and got completely purified and had love for the Lord awakened in his heart. Why did that not happen with Prajapati Daksha? On having the Lord Darshan, Dhruva Maharaj's material desire were no more. But Daksha still had material desires. Kindly explain, Gurudev. Hare Krishna, Gurudev, 我卑微的顶拜。 Prajapati Daksha 的物质愿望为什么没有得到完全的净化？ 而且也没有唤醒出对主的这种爱在他内心，而这个。 这种事情为什么没有发生在 Prajapati Daksha 的身上呢？就是说，Dhruva Maharaj 见到了主之后，他内心得到了净化，而且唤醒了对主的爱。但是为什么这样的事情没有在 Prajapati Daksha 身上出现呢？他也得到了主的 darshan。
Well, one possible reason is that Dhruva Maharaj was blessed with the association and instruction of a pure devotee in the form of Narada Muni.
第一个可能性的原因是，Dhruva Maharaj 可能得到纯粹奉献者的联谊，以及纯粹奉献者给予他的训示，他执行的这个训示，这个纯粹奉献者就是 Narada Muni.
Yeah, when Dhruva Maharaj was entering the forest, Narada Muni came to him, and Narada Muni tried to test him and discouraged him, told him, "You're very young, better you go back," but Dhruva was very determined.
当Dhruva Maharaj 准备要去森林里面做苦行的时候，他遇见了 Narada Muni. Narada Muni 本来想打消他的积极性，但是Dhruva Maharaj 非常的有决心。So
Dhruva Maharaj followed the instructions of Narada Muni carefully, and in 6 months he was able to see the Lord.
Dhruva Maharaj 很小心地从事着 Narada Muni 给予他的训示，然后6个月之后，他见到了主。
Now, when the Lord appeared to Dhruva Maharaj, then Dhruva Maharaj said, "Now I am fully satisfied. Now I don't want anything."
当主在Dhruva Maharaj 面前显现的时候，Dhruva Maharaj 说，现在我已经满足了。
But the Lord told Dhruva Maharaj, "No, I know you want a kingdom, so now you have to take the kingdom. I want you to go and you go to the pole star. Well, first you will stay here in this, on this planet. You'll stay here, you'll become the king, you'll take your father's place and become the ruler, and you'll rule for many, many years. And then you will go to the pole star and you'll live there.
朱阿玛拉吉在见到了主之后，他说：“我什么都不想要了。”但是主跟他说：“我知道你很想要一个王国，你不行，你先在这个物质世界管你的这个世界，然后呢，在这个世界待一段时间之后，你去到北极星，在那里掌管这个世界。”
And Dhruva Maharaj is still in the pole star there.
Dhruva Maharaj 现在还在北极星上。
And at the end of Brahma's day, then he will leave.
在 Brahma 的最后的一天的时候，他会离开那里。
So you have to be very careful what you desire, that even though you may lose your desire, the Lord remembers your desire. And he remembers why.
所以我们得很小心我们的愿望，即便你失去了你的这个愿望，但是主会记得你的这个愿望。
Yes.
Okay. Next question from Dopati Maharaj, Dimbai Gurudev. Daksha 是伟大的灵魂，但也有冒犯。为了完成创造去苦行。 而这却是个物质愿望，为了继续在这个世界生存和灵性修持，我能祈祷得到一份工作这样的欲望吗？还是不管情况怎样，只是去念诵 Hare Krishna， 好像太难做到了。Obeisance to Gurudev, Daksha is a great soul, but he also have he need to create, so he do some austerities, but this is also material desires. So for continually stay in this material and in this material world, and also do some spiritual practice, should I pray the Lord I can get a job? This kind of material desire, or in whatever condition, I just need to chant the Hare Krishna. It seems that it is very hard to do that.
Well, yes, it's better you just chant Hare Krishna. I know it's hard for you, but as a woman, your duty is to take care of your child, and actually duty is more to be at home and take care of your child.
是的，最好是念诵 Hare Krishna. 当然，这对一个对于你来说有一点难。作为一个女性，她的职责是照顾孩子，在家里面。
You're not meant to be working in a factory all the time.
你不意味着你要去到一个工厂里面，总是在那里工作。You're
meant to simply take care of your home and serve your husband and take care of your children.
你应该去照顾你的家庭，照顾你的孩子，照顾你的丈夫。
Of course, nowadays in China, all the women are working, so you may want to, you're thinking you want to be like other women.
当然现在的中国，所有女性都有工作，你可能也想一想，你可能也想像其他的女性一样去工作。
That way you get more money, you have more money to spend, more.
这样的话你就有更多的钱，你就可以花更多的钱。
So that's your sense gratification, to go shopping, to spend money.
那是你的感官享乐，你可以去购物，你可以花钱。
But If you could just take shelter of the holy name, that would be better for you. Okay.
Okay.
Hare Krishna. Good day.
Hare Krishna.
Yes, Sati.
Yeah, 我们现场奉献者有个问题想提问，最后一个问题好吗？最后一个问题。嗯，可以吗？随便。
You just mentioned that Dhruva Maharaj will leave the planet, leave the pole star, or Dhruva Loka at the end of Brahma's life. But but Dhruva Loka is a spiritual planet, so why he leave this spiritual planet? I mean, he is already situated in the spiritual world.
First of all, I didn't say at the end of his life, I said at the end of Brahma's day.
Sorry, Guru Maharaj. Sorry, Maharaj. The end of the Brahma's day.
So, you're saying Dhruva Loka is a spiritual planet? So why does Dhruva Maharaj need to leave it?
Yes, Maharaj.
Well, he wants to go back to the spiritual world. In the spiritual world, he can enjoy the pastimes with the Supreme Lord. At the pole star, he's responsible for all the planets. They're all rotating around the pole star. And so he's engaged in some administrative duties there. And of course, the Supreme Lord, Lord Shirodakashaya Vishnu, is residing there on the pole star. Lord Vishnu is also there. He's with Dhruva Maharaj. But Dhruva Maharaj will naturally want to go back to the spiritual world where he can get, he can be with the Lord in his eternal abode.
Dhruva Maharaj想离开那个地方，是因为在这个北极星上，他可能做的一些管理的事务。虽然Shirodakshaya Vishnu也在那儿，他和主在一起。但是离开那个地方，他可以回到主在宁信世界原本的这个星球，可以参加逍遥时光。As
you said, the pole star is eternal, but all the other planets in the universe are not eternal. And so when there's annihilation at the end of Brahma's life, or even a partial annihilation at the end of Brahma's day, then many of the planets are all, they all enter into the body of Mahavishnu. So what happens to the pole star when all the other planets are annihilated? The pole star at that time, because there's an annihilation of the material world, so at that time the pole star simply becomes invisible.
So in the material, in the world, 关于北极星，它到底会发生什么呢？在毁灭的时候，这个所有的星球都进入到主威中的体内之后，北极星它处于不显现隐性的这种状态，隐藏的这种状态之中，看不见。And
then when the creation takes place again, that time then the pole star becomes manifest.
当创造再次发生的时候，北极星也展现出来。
So Dhruva Maharaj, naturally, he wants to go back to the spiritual world, to the eternal abode with all the pure devotees.
So Dhruva Maharaj's
material world, not a very pleasant place? Yeah?
Okay. Thank you very much, Maharaj. Thank you.
All right, Sati, you want me to stop here now, is it? You want to do something? Sati, Nishiman, what was that really thing? 现在现场没有其他更新者提问了，然后。Okay. Go back to Vrindaki.
Yeah.
Haribo.